Now, it's really important that you understand PDUs or protocol data units and how encapsulation and de-encapsulation works. And to help me explain that, I'm going to go back to using Packet Tracer as well as my three laptops. I've got laptop one over here, laptop two over there, as well as this laptop, which is acting as our server. So I'm going to show you how it works with real devices as well as with Packet Tracer. As I always like to say, you're going to learn so much more if you do stuff yourself, either with physical devices, but if you don't have that, use Packet Tracer and build labs. I've attached to this topology to the course so that you can download this and practice for yourself. But let's cover some of the theory first. The idea here is that we have an application, could be a web browser, could be some other type of application that wants to send data into the network. So we have our user data. When the data is sent from the application layer to the transport layer, it's broken up into segments, depending on how big the data is. So we have a piece of the user data that is then encapsulated with a layer 4 header. So a header is put on because, remember, if we're using TCP at layer 4 here, TCP running locally on the local source computer needs to talk to TCP on the other side. So the data is encapsulated with a layer 4 header. Something similar happens when we go to the next layer. At layer 3, we have packets. Layer 4 then sends the segment to the transport layer that adds a new header, a layer 3 header. This is known as a packet. So notice we have the original data encapsulated with a layer 4 header, which is encapsulated with a layer 3 header. At this layer, we may have a TCP or UDP header. And at this layer, we might have an IP version 4 or say an IPv6 header. Depends on which protocols you're using. So headers are added at each layer. In the same way, layer 3 sends the packet to layer 2. And a new header is added, a layer 2 header. This is known as a frame. Frame check sequence is also added to the frame to make sure that the frame hasn't been corrupted in transmission. This could be an Ethernet 2 header, or if we went across a serial link, it would be PPP or HDLC. Different encapsulations are used at layer 2. This could be TCP or UDP. This could be IP version 4, and this could be Ethernet. The frame is now transmitted at the physical layer as bits. So if you captured traffic on the wire, you'd see a bunch of binary values, so zeros and ones. The actual transmission, once again, if it's fiber, it would be light. If it was copper, it would be electrical signals. And if it was Wi-Fi, electromagnetic signals sent through the air. So the network interface card in your PC now transmits those bits, in this example, as a light across the cable. And the network interface card on the other end receives that information. So let's assume that that's now transmitted across the wire or through the air to the receiving party. So the network interface card is receiving those bits as pulses of light in this example. The network interface card then needs to read the destination MAC address and see if it's destined to itself. And then what it's going to do is strip off the layer 2 header and send it to the upper layers. So in other words, send it to the operating system or send it to the computer. So again, the network interface card receives those bits, pulses of light or electrical signals. It's receiving the frame with the layer 2 header. The layer 2 header has the destination MAC address in it, as an example. The network interface card determines that, you know, is this frame meant for me or for someone else? If it's meant for the local device, it's going to receive that, process it, and then strip the layer 2 header and send that to the next layer. So the network interface card is once again stripping the layer 2 frame, sending the packet to layer 3, and the protocol, which could be IP version 4, or IPv6, or in the old days, another protocol is going to receive that. On a Windows computer, the easiest way to visualize this is to go to Control Panel, which hopefully still exists when you watch this video. Go to Network and Internet, Network and Sharing Center, change adapter settings, and have a look at one of your adapters. So in this example, I'm going to go to Properties of this adapter, and notice it's running multiple protocols here. We've got the IP version 4 protocol stack as well as the IP version 6 protocol stack. Protocol stack is essentially what we're looking at here. So at layer 2, we've got Ethernet, then we've got IP version 4, and then we've got TCP or UDP. Different protocols could be used. When the network interface card receives the pulses of light, it processes the frame. The network interface card determines, is this for IP version 6 or IP version 4? So which protocol is the frame destined to? The field of value that determines that is known as the type field. And I'm going to show you what Ethernet looks like in a moment. In the Ethernet 2 frame, we have this thing called a type field that tells the network interface card, is this for IP version 4 or is this for IP version 6? Who should it send it to in the upper layers? I'll focus on Ethernet once again because Ethernet is what we use in the real world. Type field is what Ethernet 2 uses to determine IP version 4, IP version 6, or perhaps another protocol, an older protocol like NetBEUI or IPX, which we don't use today. So layer 2 header is removed, goes to, let's say, IP version 4. The computer determines, is this packet for me or is it for someone else? Now, the processing of this could be on the network card. It could be on the computer. In traditional environments, it's the CPU that's processing this information and determining is the destination IP address for the local computer or another computer. Let's say it is for the local computer. So what we're going to do now is strip this header and send the segment to the next layer. And something similar is going to happen here. Notice TCP at this layer is reading layer 4. IP version 4 at this layer is reading this header. The network interface card is reading the Ethernet header at this layer. They are stripping the headers. And then what should happen is the data ends up at the application. And what then happens is once all the headers are stripped, the actual data is sent to the application. So the user data ends up at the application and can be used by the application running on the computer. So remember, we have a PC sending data to another PC, excuse my bad drawings, and the application used here is HTTP. HTTP is communicating to HTTP. Now, in our example, in the real world, we are using an application like Chrome. But remember, there's a difference between the application and the application protocol. Chrome or Firefox or some other browser uses the HTTP or HTTPS or TLS applications to communicate. The sending device and the receiving device both have to use the same application protocol to be able to communicate. I couldn't, as an example, use HTTP to communicate with another application that doesn't support HTTP. Let's say a Telnet application. Different protocol, different language. They have to agree on the same language to communicate. So again, at layer 2, we use the type number to determine the protocol at layer 3. At layer 3, the protocol number determines which protocol is being used at layer 4. So again, here we've got type to indicate is it IP version 4 or IP version 6. Here we've got protocol number, is it TCP or is it UDP? And at layer 4, we determine the application by the port number. You'll see famous port numbers like port 80 for HTTP or port 443 for HTTPS or TLS or port 23 for Telnet, port 22 for SSH. These are port numbers determining the application that's listening on that port. These port numbers denote well-known applications listening on a specific port. So if I enable a service like an HTTP server, I can determine which port number it's going to listen on. By default, it would be 80, but I could use, for instance, 8080. That's a setting inside the application that you're using.